For many marine species, especially marine vertebrates, there's many threats out in the oceans, ranging from climate change to fisheries interactions and pollution, which we know is becoming a major issue.
The marine research at the University of Exeter is very broad and sees us working on things from the very smallest viruses all the way up to ecosystems, and work spanning from the poles all the way down to the equator.
And one of the things that really sets us apart here is a focus on conservation and management of the natural environment.
And we're also able to use state-of-the-art technologies to measure aspects of the ocean, underwater noise, presence of dolphins, things like side-scanned seabed sonar, all sorts of different technologies that really put sort of shape and flavour and colour into what we're seeing our animals doing underwater.
But we're also using drones to develop models of nesting beaches so that we can look at what impact sea level rise will have.
At the moment, we're working on developing a partnership with Global Fishing Watch to use satellite-derived information on where fishing vessels are so we can understand things like illegal fishing activity.
I've been working on sea turtles for over 30 years, studying their conservation, but also their ecology, their migration. We have helped develop conservation programs that have seen some populations recover from very small numbers towards numbers that might be getting close to natural levels.
We've been working on Ascension Island for the past 25 years with the local government there. And that kind of partnership is fantastic because it means that our research is going straight to the policymakers and leading to change. And in that case, it led to one of the largest marine protected areas being designated.
I think the impact of this work has been several-fold, and it's useful for governments to set policy, for us to work out how to actually conserve animals, how to actually do stuff that's going to help them to get a break, to breed more and to increase their numbers and become more abundant in our waters around our coasts.
One of the things that Exeter Research has been particularly good at is looking at how communities influence the outcomes of conservation, and good outcomes come from intensive processes of community engagement to develop shared goals for nature and for livelihoods.
The challenge does seem great, but once amplified by the interactions with governments, coastal communities, international NGOs, we believe that we can start to help affect the change that is needed for the preservation of marine biodiversity, but also the human well-being that's resulted from that.